My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ اللَّهَ غَافِلًا عَمَّا يَعْمَلُ الظَّالِمُونَ إِنَّمَا يُؤَخِّرُهُمْ لِيَوْمٍ تَشْخَصُ فِيهِ الْأَبْصَارِ. Do not ever presume, do not ever think that Allah is unaware of what the ظالم, of what the wicked and the unrighteous and the transgressors are doing. Don't think that just because you feel justice is going unchecked, that Allah is unaware of what is justice. وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ اللَّهَ غَافِلًا عَمَّا يَعْمَلُ الظَّالِمُونَ. Don't presume that Allah is not aware of what is going on. Allah sees the ظلم and Allah knows the ظلم. But Allah says that I know when to take account of the ظلم. And if it's in this world, it shall be in this world. But for sure, every ظلم, every injustice shall be taken account in the next word, in the next world. إِنَّمَا يُؤَخِّرُهُمْ. For sure Allah will deal with them on that day, that on that day that their eyes will be staring in fear. تَشْخَصُ فِيهِ الْأَبْصَارِ مُهْطِعِينَ مُقْنِعِ رُؤُوسِهِمْ. They will be terrified, rushing forwards, their heads raised up. مُقْنِعِ رُؤُوسِهِمْ لَا يَرْتَدُّ إِلَيْهِمْ طَرْفُهُمْ. They will not even be blinking. وَأَفْئِدَتُهُمْ هَوَى. And their hearts will be empty, dreading with terror their meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Allah reminds us in the Quran that ظلم will never go unchecked, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take account of injustice. And the Quran and Sunnah is full of warning against the evil of ظلم. In fact, it can truly be said that ظلم is of the worst matters that Allah warns us against. Over 120 verses in the Quran mention the evils of ظلم. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in a hadith Qudsi, our Prophet said that Allah said, Ya ibadi, inni harramtu dhulma ala nafsi. O my servants, I have made dhulm haram for myself. I do not commit dhulm. I do not do injustice. Waja'altuhu baynakum muharrama. And I have made dhulm haram between you. Fala tadhalamu. So make sure you do not do dhulm to one another. Make sure you are not unjust to one another. And Allah threatens those who do dhulm, that Allah says in the Quran, وَسَيَعْلَمُ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا أَيَّ مُنْقَلَبٍ يَنْقَلِبُونَ. Those who do dhulm, those who did injustice, they shall see the fate that shall await them. They're going to know that fate. Allah does not mention what that fate will be because it is a threat. Let those who do dhulm wait. They shall see what I have stored for them. وَسَيَعْلَمُ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا أَيَّ مُنْقَلَبٍ يَنْقَلِبُونَ. Brothers and sisters in Islam, it is a part and parcel of human history that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continuously tests people throughout history with evil rulers over and over again. This is the cycle of human existence. Every few generations, another ruler comes along and this ruler demonstrates the worst of humanity and commits the greatest of atrocities. It's not the first time. It shall not be the last time that we are seeing such rulers. Allah reminds us in the Quran, أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ فَعْلَ رَبُّكَ بِعَاد. Haven't you seen what your Lord did with Aad? وَإِرَمْ ذَاتِ الْعِمَاد. And Iram, the people of pillars, those magnificent pillars. وَثَمُودَ الَّذِينَ جَابُوا الصَّخْرَ بِالْوَاد. And Thamud, who would carve their houses into the mountains. And they did things that nobody else did. وَثَمُودَ الْجَابُ الْصَخْرَ بِالْوَادِ وَفِرْعَوْنَ ذِي الْأَوْتَادِ. And Fir'aun, the one who had awtad, awtad here means pillars that he would torture people on. Fir'aun, the one, what he would do, he would have these pillars, like the crucifix, like the cross. He would have people, he would torture them for the slightest reason. وَفِرْعَوْنَ ذِي الْأَوْتَادِ. And the Fir'aun who had these pillars. What does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say? فَصَبَّ عَلَيْهِمْ رَبُّكَ سَوْطَ عَذَابٍ. Your Lord poured upon them every type of punishment. Inna rabbaka labil mirsad. Verily your Lord is watching and knows exactly what they are doing. Ad, Iram, Thamud, Fir'aun. They were worse than any tyrant we have ever seen. They were worse than the tyrants we are seeing today, even if it appears that these tyrants are trying to imitate them. But they were worse than them. And what does Allah say in the Quran? فَصَبَّ عَلَيْهِمْ رَبُّكَ سَوْطَ عَذَابٍ Your Lord poured upon them every type of punishment imaginable. إِنَّ رَبَّكَ لَبِالْمِرْصَادِ Verily your Lord is watching what they are doing. Brothers and sisters, our hope is that inshaAllah ta'ala, what we are seeing in the lands of Bilad al-Sham is the same promise that Allah gave the believers at the time of Musa. It is the same promise that He told the Bani Israel at the time of Musa. Because this person is clearly walking on the footsteps of Fir'aun. And the believers in Sham, inshaAllah ta'ala, are walking on the footsteps of the believers in the time of the Prophet ﷺ, in the time of Musa. But verily the promise of Allah will come true, and Allah will help His religion, and Allah will aid His believers. It will happen. وَلَكِنَّكُمْ قَوْمٌ تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ But you are people who are hasty. You cannot wait for the results. You want them right here and right now. And of the perfection of Allah's justice, and listen to this carefully, brothers and sisters, of the perfection of Allah's justice, the one who has been wronged shall have the right to judge on Judgment Day. On Judgment Day, Allah Himself will allow the mazloom to decide should the zalim be punished or not. And that's why Ibn al-Qayyim said, this dhulm is the most scary type of dhulm. Because the third category of dhulm is the dhulm that you have between you and Allah as your personal private sins. That dhulm, he said, is the easiest because Allah is ghafoor and Allah is raheem and Allah forgives the repentant and Allah forgives the one who does good. But the second category of dhulm, that is the one you have to be careful of. Because even if Allah decides to forgive His haqq, you still have to worry about the haqq of the one you have done dhulm to. And on that day, every person whose blood has been spilt, every person whose money has been taken, whose honor has been ripped away, every woman who has lost her dignity, every child that has been murdered, justice will be in their hands. And they will be able to decide, and Allah will give them full rights to do as they please. And that is why our Prophet ﷺ warned us, beware of doing dhulm, because it will be converted to dhulumat on Judgment Day. Dhulm raises the status of the mazloom. The mazloom becomes the most powerful human being because of the dhulm. The one who has been wronged becomes the most powerful because of the dhulm. And the strongest dua ever is the dua of the one who has been done dhulm to. Dhulm, Allah Himself gives the right to prosecute to the one whom dhulm was done to. Al-Ghafoor and Al-Rahim takes a step back and gives that right to the one whom dhulm was done to. So who amongst us will ever forgive the zalim? Who amongst us will have that maghfirah that will forgive the zalim? No other sin is there that Allah Azza wa Jal hands over the right to the person to deal with, except for dhulm. Every sin that we do between us and Allah, and inshaAllah, Allah is ghafoor and Allah is raheem. That's why our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَا يَزَالُ الْمَرْءُ فِي فُسْحَةٍ مِّن دِينِهِ A man remains at comfort in his religion, no matter what sin he does, as long as he does not spill somebody's blood. When you spill somebody's blood, that is when you are in serious trouble. This is what our Prophet ﷺ warned us about. There's always some leeway in your personal sins. Your personal sins, inshaAllah, turn to Allah. Allah will forgive you. But when you turn to dhulm, Allah Himself has said, it is not my right to forgive. It is the right of the mazloom to forgive. Who wants to be put in that position, brothers and sisters? Dhulm is indeed dhulumat on the Day of Judgment. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to always protect us from ever doing dhulm. Barakallahu alaykum fi al-Qur'an al-Azim. Wa nafi'ani wa iyaakum bima fihi ma'ati wa dhikr al-Hakim. Aqulu ma tasma'un wa astaghfirullah al-Azim li wa lakum. Wa li sa'il muslimin kulli dhanbin fastaghfiruhu innahu huwa al-ghafurur rahim.